Hello friends, there are three parts in the communication. Number one, what you speak. Number two, where you speak. And the most important component in the process of communication is how you speak. That is why this how you speak, that carries the highest component in the process of communication. Hi, my name is Pankaj Sharma. I am an author, trainer and a speaker. Today I'll be going to share with you few important things in the process of communication, and most important thing, the communication, what you do that makes you successful in the profession of sales. So doesn't matter if you are in any industry, but if you are in the business of sales, this video will be very useful to you. So my question to you, have you ever thought of that why do you able to close the calls, and the calls which you are unable to close, what were the reason? The most important reason and the cause the sales do not close after having, you know, tremendous efforts is the communication skills. So how good you are in it, you are at communication skills, that plays a very important role in the any transaction what you do with the customer. So the important thing here, when you go for the communication and especially in the sales, the most important thing is the prospecting. Prospecting doesn't mean only writing the names of the customers, of the prospect or the probable or the possible customers. Prospecting is similar to what you see in the banks normally. People are asking for KYC, know your customer. So when you do for the, you know, business transaction with the customer in the profession of sales, know your customer is one of the most important thing. What are the different ways by which you can know about your customer more? Number one, gather as much as information possible. I have seen many people, those who are working in the insurance industry, they are struggling in terms of, you know, getting the customer attention, and they are after the customer for the continuous follow-up for selling their product. But the most important thing, have you understood the need of the customer? That is called the prospecting. In the process of prospecting, you gather the entire information, profile about the customer, about his family profile, about his profession, about his personal and professional profile. So that possibly help you to understand your customer in the holistic perspective. And that is why when you create the aura, when you create the situation, and when you do the fact finding, or when you do entire customer analysis, you know, the important thing is you will be able to understand that where actually you need to work upon. What are the important impulses or the weaknesses or the area where your customer is really thinking about? What are the pain area of your customer? It's all about winning the customer by fulfilling their need, not about your need. What problem is there with most of the salesmen? They are after the customer and they are absolutely meeting the customer with the intention of just selling the product or the brand. It's not about selling the product. It's all about understanding your customer. Say for an example, you are going to see a doctor because of any infection or any disease. Number one thing, what happens? Doctor examines you. Number two, what happens? After examining, doctor diagnoses the problem and the issue, and then doctor gives the prescription. Your product, your solution is the prescription for the customer. So whenever you are going to meet your customer to sell your product or your brand, remember the important thing, your product is the prescription to the customer. And if you are just thinking only about reaching the prescription, that is the product selling, it will not going to work. So what will help you? Absolutely examining the customer. And this prospecting or knowing your customer will help you in terms of examining your customer. So know your customer, gather as much as information possible before you go and see the customer, before you take an interview, before you take an appointment with the customer. So important thing, gather most of the information. Number two, when it comes to meeting the customer, is it possible for you to just ask few questions and try to understand out of my 5-6 questions where my customer is little more attentive? More attentive means whenever you are talking about all these points, your customer takes special interest. It changes his facial expression, it changes his you know, the movement of his eyeball, and then you will be able to understand, okay, fine, this is one of the cause where my customer may be in the need. Then you take upon that point further and you discuss about the solution about your product. So this is what, you know, the most important thing. When you talk about your product, you should know about complete profiling of the customer. And second, before you pitching your product to the customer, tell him that how it product will going to be helpful in terms of giving the solution to their problems. So this is what, you know, the most important thing in the profession of sales, and that will help you to become a successful salesman. No matter you are working in insurance industry, you are working in communication industry, you are working in pharmaceutical industry, you are working in textile industry, these are the basics of your customer. So remember always three steps. Number one is examining, like doctor is examining you. If you are going to meet a doctor, doctor never goes, never take you to the operation theater for, you know, operation and the surgeries. Doctor always examining you. Doctor always trying to find out what the problem is there. Doctor always wanted to understand whether it is a bacterial infection, viral infection or something else. If it is a fever, it is a viral fever, bacterial fever, or a fever because of any infection in the body. Likewise, your job is also like a consultant. So if you are selling any product, if you are selling any brand, if you are selling anything, you are not only the salesman, you are the consultant to whom your customer can consult and customer can rely on. So first of all, examine your customer. Number two, diagnose the problem with the customer. What is the need of the customer? If you are working in the insurance, it's the children's study, and you know the future of the children is the concern area for the customer. Retirement life is the concern area for the customer, or maybe the long-term family financial planning is the concern for the customer. If you are working in pharmaceutical industry, find out what your customer is absolutely needing. What are the pain area where your customer is absolutely confused in terms of taking the right molecule for the right treatment of their patients, and understand that, find out that, and then discuss that particular thing. That is called the right diagnosis. So when you diagnose the right problem, you can pitch, you can place, you can offer your absolutely available solution to the customer, and you will see there's a difference between now understanding the customer's problem, and that is called the examining and diagnosis the problem, and then you go for the absolute treatment. That's called the prescription. So when you give the prescription, show him what are the benefits are there, not the benefit for you, the benefit for the customer, right? So that is why that will possibly help you in terms of closing more calls. So this is all about the communication in the profession of sales. Hope this is useful to you. If this is useful to you, share it with others. So once again, my name is Pankaj Sharma. Do subscribe my channel, like and share with as much as people possible. Thank you so much for watching.